Hi, I'm Heather at the Kraaft Shaak, where we believe all were created by the Creator to be creative. Join me now for another art adventure. Hello and welcome to Heather's Art Adventure. Thank you so much for joining. Today we're going to be painting this zippered pouch using acrylic paints and a fabric medium. And to find out more about those details, you'll want to visit our blog at kraaftshaak.com. So it was my mom's birthday this month, and I wanted to make her something that I knew she would like and use. And she loves the tote bags so much that, you know, there's only one flaw with tote bags. There's no place to put anything. So I wanted to get her this little zippered pouch where you could put little things into the pouch and then drop the pouch into the tote bag and then fish out the zippered pouch out of the tote bag, right? You know what I'm talking about. Anyway, it was a pretty magenta and orange and peach and pretty colors like that dragonfly that I saw as a reference. And it's pretty big. So I was really kind of excited to paint this. I don't know that I've ever painted such a detailed dragonfly before, but I do love dragonflies, and so does my mom. And she also loves the color magenta. But as you'll see, I kind of changed my mind a little bit about the color choices and struggle a bit with that, but we're going to watch how we do this. So I do use a fabric medium that helps with spreading the paint out onto the canvas a little bit, but what it really helps with is when you go to wash this tote, or this, in this case, it's a zippered pouch, when you go to wash it in the washing machine, the fabric medium will hold the acrylic paint on the canvas. It makes it more pliable. It allows it to stay on during washings and things like that. So it's a good help if you are painting fabrics that you would like to launder. So you'll see here I'm kind of adding some yellowy orange into this, and I really didn't love it. I did not love it. So I pretty much paint over it right away, and I will attempt to paint in some oranges as we go, but it doesn't make me happy. So I end up doing almost an entirely magenta dragonfly, which also didn't make me happy. So I bring in some other silly little products, and I ended up having a lot of fun with this. So I do speed ups part of this video. It did take me about 40 minutes start to finish, with a few moments of looking for paint or letting it dry in between or any of those kinds of things. But basically, I'm just trying to get the shapes down, make sure that I have symmetry between the left and right wings. And you'll see me using my fingers to measure, just to make sure I get the right shaping down. And I'm not too worried about the edges. You can kind of tell it's a little rough edge because this is an unprepared canvas. So the bag itself is truly canvas, unprepared canvas. And so if you've ever tried to paint on canvas before, you know that you do need some kind of primer on it, so to speak. I'm using air quotes, like you can see me using my fingers to do quotation marks. Yeah, so you want to put down like gesso or something like that. Well, I didn't really want to do that with this small bag because it would be very stiff. I've learned painting tote bags and things that the gesso does make it very stiff, and it loosens up after you put it in the washing machine, but I didn't want this little bag to have that stiffness to it. So my intention was to just paint and use a lot of paint to get those wings put on there. And so you see me just sort of blocking in the shapes. That's what I'm doing here. And I'm not too worried about the edges. Like I said, we'll clean those up as we go. And this is where I kind of realized that I wasn't really loving the color choices. I didn't feel like it was popping very much. I wanted it to be a little bit more muddled, and I really wanted those wings to appear to be more transparent or more translucent, and it wasn't working out that way. So how do I provide that translucency or give that appearance with an opaque acrylic paint? And I'm going to struggle with it. I'm just going to tell you the truth. I'm going to struggle with it. The other thing was, at this point, I'm like, okay, well, what colors do I want? If I don't really love this orangey magenta blend, what colors do I want? And I started thinking rainbow. It would be nice to add like all the colors. And I don't know. It didn't quite go the way I wanted it to go, but I ended up loving it anyway. I mean, how could you not? Look at the butterfly. I mean, dragonfly. Sorry. I may call it a butterfly like 14 times, just so you know. So now I'm just trying to fix the shaping and make sure that the left and the right match shape wise. They are not going to really match as far as like the colors that I have in there, because as I'm working on this, I'm thinking, I'm not really sure which colors I'm going to put exactly. So see how it goes. Just defining the edges right now and making sure that they are a little bit straighter, that the shaping is pretty much what I want it to be. And I, like I said, I do speed this up throughout this video, but I wanted to also give you some of the real-time painting strokes as well. So it's sort of a, I hope anyway, a happy combination of both, to get through it a little quicker, but then to not make it one of those dizzy super speed videos at the same time. Okay, so as I am adding some purple in now, I'm thinking this is like a metallic purple. It's got a, you know, a pretty metallic finish to it. It's going to be a nice little addition to the tips of these wings. You will not even see that in the finished piece, but I thought it was going to add to the rainbow look that I was maybe going for, but I even grabbed this metallic blue, this really, I mean, look at how bright that blue is. I grabbed that thinking, okay, that's going to be a good accent for these weird markings that the dragonfly has. And right away, I didn't like it. Like, I was like, I don't know, I don't know. But I'm trying to stick with it. I'm trying to... It's very much hard. This is where I have a really hard time, is choosing colors that I think the recipient is going to want. So it's one thing when I'm painting something that I see in my mind, but it's a whole nother thing when it's a gift for someone, because, you know, I want to make sure that it's something that she's going to love and that she's going to enjoy. And, you know, as most moms, of course she's going to love anything I make her, but I really want her to like it. Like, that was really the goal, right? So I started painting some of these markings on the back of this dragonfly, and they're kind of weird. So we're going to go over some of that as we go, but back to the wings. So now that they've dried, and you can kind of see on the tips that metallic sheen, it's a real fun effect, but it's not going to stick around for long. But I decided to get a smaller brush and try to get a little bit more detailed edging. And then this is kind of where things got a little weird. I tried a couple of different colors. I tried a couple of different things. I ended up wiping them off because it didn't work. And I realized that it was just too dark. So I go in with some white to kind of lighten it up and give it a little bit of, the idea is to make it look a little bit more transparent, right? And so I'm just trying to go in where leaving the the darker to be more like the veins, and I realized that wasn't going to work. So then I started doing these like little dibble dabbles. That's a technical term. And that actually made me feel more like it was a transparent, like a little bit more. It's not. It's very opaque, obviously, but it does definitely gives the appearance of being more wispy wings than the solid pink-orange wings were. And kind of see some movement in it now. So I think it was working. I definitely felt better about this than I did about the solid colored wings. That didn't really make me happy. So then I took a little bit of that blue and kind of put it in there to give it some of that iridescence look, sort of. I don't know. And I think that's when it occurred to me. I'm like, yeah, that kind of looks iridescent. And then I thought, oh, wait, iridescent. I think I have some iridescent paints. I think I have stuff I should go and look in my stash, try to find. And so that's what I do. And I found this folk art glitterific is what it's called. And it's basically a clear gloss. They call it acrylic paint, but it is very not like paint. It is like, it's glue. It's very sticky, thick, gooey stuff. And this particular one that I grabbed is a like a green glitter chunks in it. And again, all the supplies I used will be listed on my blog post, so you can see exactly which one I'm talking about. But it had like shards of green glitter in it, and I mixed it. Typically, it's clear. The gel that it's in is clear, but it looks really milky right now. And that's because I mixed it with the fabric medium, thinking, you know, I want it to be flexible and, you know, go through the wash and all that. But it never really dries clear. It kind of stays this milky finish. And I was not expecting. You can kind of see in that bottom wing on the left side there, you can see that it's got some shiny glitter chunks in it. But so for this top one, I used the same product, but it's a pink. And I did not mix it with the fabric medium. And see how there's no milkiness to this. I'm just putting down, it's very thick, gooey product. But it's got chunks of glitter in it, and when it dries, it is, I don't know what the words are, other than magical. Oh, look at that sparkle. Yeah, so it's kind of weird that stuff in the bottom stayed milky and it dried milky, but still pretty. So I thought that I would add some black or dark blue or purple or something like that to those eyes. I immediately stopped myself because I thought it was going to look a little too buggy. And then I used that metallic purple from the tips of the wings to kind of go in and make some more of those markings, and I really didn't like that at all. So I'm going back in with the blue, and we're going to try to make that the body more of a solid blue than the markings that were on it. I think it just looked too, it was too realistic with all the glitter in the wings. Like it's very fantastical, and I didn't want it to look that way. The realistic, I mean, buggy. I don't know. All right, so here we are with my Pentel brush, and this is filled with India ink. So it's going to dry permanent, but I'm using the tip to just create these fine, jagged, vein lines of the wings. But I'm not really drawing everyone in or anything like that. I'm just sort of letting the brush very lightly go over in places. And I didn't outline the entire wing. I left, I let it skip over the top because it's just real sketchy that way. I want you to know that these are wings, but I don't want it to be a precise drawing. See what I mean? It just sort of skips over. Think that helped because it was weird with that milkiness in there. I think that really helped define it. And I know you can't tell in these pictures or in this video, but it has got a lot of green and very rainbowy colors to it. When it hits the light, it's very pretty. I really enjoyed making this bag, and I really like painting on tote bags and all kinds of canvas things anyway. So this is just one more of those fun gifts I really enjoy making. I really didn't have a plan for this. I just knew I wanted to paint a dragonfly on there for her and then let it go from there. Boy, the sparkles, aren't they great? Get a nice close-up look after it's dried. Really, really pretty. So shiny, so sparkly. So here I decided that I really wanted to have a message stamped on it, and I'm using these archival inks because they are permanent. It might fade a little bit over time as she washes it, but it'll be okay. And so I used a clear stamp and just sort of made it like the both stamp both inks on it so that it kind of has an ombre to it. And I'm holding it on there, but I didn't do it enough. But because it's a clear stamp and I have the guts, I'm going to go ahead and ink it up again, really, really good. And then carefully put my head right over the top, make sure I'm right over those letters. Push it down, and then I'm going to hold it there on that canvas for quite a while. This is not sped up. This is as long as it took for me to do this, so that you can see that it'll give a little bit darker image and be stamped a little bit better. And I'm pushing down fairly well because I wanted to make sure that the ink is penetrating into that canvas bag. And I think that worked out really well. We did pretty good there. The last step, because I felt it was a little plain, was to get my acrylic sprays and make a mess. And again, the items that I used will be listed on my blog post, but I kind of got a little crazy with this because I made a pretty good mess, right? About, oh, let's see. I'm like, ooh, there's a big blob. I don't know if I wanted it to be a big blob. Oh, no, I don't like it when I do that. Let's see. I hope you can see this on camera. Oh, yeah, right there. Yeah, big blob. Big, big blob. That's all right. Get a little paper towel and dab it up. No big deal. Do you ever do this? Do you ever just like go a little too far? Make a little bit too much mess? I'm hurrying up and grabbing my paper towel right now. That's what that is. Anyway, I'll do a few splatters on the front, nothing like this, and then that'll be it. So I really do appreciate you guys watching, and I hope that you've enjoyed it. I hope you will give it a thumbs up. If you haven't yet subscribed, please consider subscribing to the channel. It does let me know that this is something you'd like to see more of. So thanks, and have a very crafty day.